My dear students, today let's begin our class with the history fourth lesson, medieval India, concept of kingship and nature of administration. The period between 1206 AD and 1526 AD in India's history is known as the Delhi Sultanate period. During this period of over 300 years, five dynasties ruled in Delhi. They are Mamluk, Khalji, Tughlaq, Said and Lodi dynasties. Siyauddin Barani here describes the views of Balban, the most important ruler of Mamluk or a Slav dynasty on kingship. Who was the founder of Mamluk or Slav dynasty? Qutbuddin Aibak. He was the founder of the Mamluk or the Slav dynasty. Other major rulers in these dynasties were Balban and Iltutmish. Okay, then the word sultanate derived from the word sult, which means power. This word refers to the authority and suzerainty of one person over the others. The administration during Delhi Sultanate was based on the laws of the Sharia or the laws of Islam. Political, legal and military authority was vested in the Sultan. Thus, military strength was the main factor in succession of throne. The sultans implemented centralized administration or centralized rule in the administrative system. What are the main features of the central administration? One of the important feature of the administrative feature of Sultanate was the influence of the Turkish tradition. We know that the Turkish tradition maintained the view that the king is equal to God. He is considered as the almighty and supreme power or sovereign power is vested in the hands of the king. That means king is considered as a god. It was from this stand point that the concept of the unlimited authority of the kingship was derived. The king rules his country just like the head of the family controls the members. His decisions would not be questioned by the members. The position of each member in the family and their right to property were determined by him. So we can say that the sultans followed the Turkish tradition. Second point feature was the sultan was the head of the administration, military and judiciary. They followed centralized administration. I already explained. And the third important feature is that there were different ministers and offices to assist the king in administration. Important officials and their duties in the central administration of the Sultanate period are given in our textbook. Then, the Wazir, his main function or duty was the revenue collection. Mamalik, the controller of the military. And Chief Sadr, and he was judiciary was under his control. And the royal correspondence was in the control of the Diwan-i Insha. Okay. Another important point is that the strong army was maintained. A strong army was maintained to defend the country from the threat of the invasions and for the expansion of the empire. Then, another important feature is that an exact law of succession was absent. The leadership of the Caliphate of Baghdad was accepted. And the vast country was divided into different regions for the convenience of administration. And last, the regional laws prevailed at the village level. Okay. There was local administrative system also. Then what are the administrative system at the local level during the Sultanate period? The administrative system at the local level was for the convenience of administration, and for that the vast empire was divided into provinces, sheikhs, parganas and villages. Another important feature of the local administration was separate officers were appointed for each division, and the authority was not hereditary. The maintenance of law and order, judicial administration, collection of taxes, and organization of the army were the chief duties of the officers. They were under the direct control of the Sultan. But the Sultan did not directly intervene in the administration of the villages. For the administrative convenience, the Sultan followed the Ikta system. The Ikta system was introduced at first by Shamsauddin Iltutmish. He established this system based on Muhammad Ghori's ideas. Its main function was only to collect tax. During the period of Sultanate, the country was divided into different parts, and these were entrusted with the nobles, who were also the military commanders. These divisions were known as Iktas. The Iktas and their holders were known in different names as Ikkadar, Mukti and Wali. Their main function, I already told, the revenue collection or tax collection. And also their influence, or they were intervened in the judicial administration of the these divisions. They were also duty bound to maintain an army of their own. They used part of the revenue collected from the Ikta for their own expenses and the rest for conducting the administration. But they were not provided with the independent authority when the administration at the center became stronger. The authority of the Ikkadars got restricted. The Ikkadars later became the provinces. The local administration for the local administrative divisions. For the local administration, the country was divided into different parts, and they were appointed different officers. And the divisions were province, sheikh, pargana, and villages. The province were under the control of Mukti or Wali, and Sheikh were under the control of Shikda, and Pargana were under the control of Amir, and village or Grama were under the control of Muktada. Okay.